Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 12.4, Developer Beta 7, and Public Beta 7. So this should be out now if you're in the beta program, and it came in at a very large 2.8 gigabytes. Now, this particular device was on Beta 6, and upgrading to Beta 7 was a massive upgrade as far as the size goes, and that usually indicates that this is probably the final version before it actually releases to the public. And I would expect that next week or something along those lines. Now let's take a look at the build number, and then we can talk about what's new. So we'll go into general, then about, and the build is 16G5077A, and this A really denotes that we're close to the final version, and we thought that last time they came out with a beta, but when we're on A, it means we pretty much are on the final version unless they find any little issues. So if you're on iOS 13 and you want to go back to this, you'll still have to use iTunes, but right now there's not really a reason to do that unless it's incredibly unstable for you. So 12.4 Beta 7 is out, and there's one small new feature, and that has to do with Apple Wallet. Since this actual version is all about the Apple Card and the new credit card from Apple, there's a new feature in Wallet. So let's go into Wallet. And once you're in Wallet, if you hit these three little dots here and you have Apple Cash set up, go in here and you'll see your balance and everything, but scroll to the bottom. And at the bottom, we have notifications for daily cash. Now, daily cash is part of the Apple Card that's coming out. And what that means is maybe you get some rewards or get some money back from Apple Card from a purchase. Say it's 3% on a purchase that was $100. It means you'd get $3 back. Well, Apple will give you that back immediately to spend on iTunes or music or whatever you'd like. And you can get notified of those transactions in daily cash right here. So it's just an extra little button that's there that wasn't there before and helps with whenever Apple Card comes out. Now, as far as anything else, there's no new modem updates. So whatever your reception is with Beta 6, it's going to be the same. And also, as far as notes or anything else, Apple doesn't even have notes for this particular beta. So that makes me think it's the final release, basically. They'll come out with this probably in a week or so. Now, as far as battery life is concerned, because I've been running the beta, I actually relied on a friend to show me their battery life. Now, they were using the Apple case, and you'll see they had the Apple charge case. So 8 hours and 35 minutes of screen on time, 34 minutes of screen off time. Most of that was with messages. And a lot of the time they did not drain their battery really that far. Sometimes they did, sometimes they didn't. And then you'll see over 24 hours, depending on the day, what they were doing, they had okay battery life. Now they did tell me that their battery life was better than Beta 5, and overall it's a better experience. As far as performance goes, this has been really fast. Zero frame rate drop so far, super smooth, no issues here. 3D Touch is working well if you have a 3D Touch enabled device. And also I ran Geekbench scores, and they came in pretty good. 4,275 for single core, 10,664 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, you'll see here we're a little bit higher than we were on the previous versions. So it's doing well. Of course, it's not any huge leaps, but it just means that it should perform as you expect or better. So that's a good sign. Now, of course, there's still a feedback app that's tied to the profile. Once the final version comes out, you can install that, remove the profile, and you'll just have the final version available to the public. And that's really all there is with this particular beta. No issues here. I did open Minecraft just to take a look at it. We can resume pretty quick. Right through here, let's see if we can go. You'll see it looks okay. Maybe there's a few frame rate drops when playing Minecraft. There definitely was right there. So that could be something with the game. Maybe it needs an update, but overall it seems pretty smooth, and it will vary from game to game. So that's really all there is with this particular beta. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you found anything else though, I'd love to hear what you have to say. And also, if you're looking for iOS 13 beta 4 or public beta 3, we were really expecting that today, so it could be later this week, it could be next week. We don't really know Apple's schedule right now on that, but they did release an update for macOS Catalina, so it's hard to say at this point. But let me know your thoughts about this in the comments below. Let me know if you're running 12.4 or iOS 13, or maybe you're even running an older device like the 5S. Performance is good on the older devices as well. I do need to fix this one as it won't turn on anymore, so I've got to either get a new one or fix the 5S. But let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.